Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe to the channel to get this great content every week. And today I have another very special guest and leader for you. Let me remind you also to acknowledge our partners. Going straight to the guest, today we have Dr. Efi Pylarinou. She's a global FinTech and tech influencer. Efi, how are you?
Thank you very much, João, for inviting me. I'm very well. I'm based here in Switzerland, and today, actually, I'm in a very beautiful place of Switzerland in the center, Interlaken, and it's a beautiful sunny day, and I can see the Alps. The close ones are green, and I can see further back the snowed Alps. So it's beautiful.
Fantastic. I've never been there. We're talking before the recording. I actually never been in Switzerland. Thank you so much for accepting my invite. You know, I've been following your great work and you are very active on social media, and I'm delighted to have you here.
Thank you very much. Delighted to be with you and discuss sort of, you know, these days, everything is interconnected. The advanced technologies are making this possible. So there's many disciplines, if you want, that are connected, that were not connected before. Since you are focused on health, I always like to say that we should soon connect wealth and health. Because, you know, wealth is all about our financial health, and the other health is about our physical, and there's many types of healths, if you want. Everything is about health, right, in some way or another.
I really like that. And the topic today is we're going to explore the true potential of wearables. And later on is a question there around health and health. But yeah. I'll save that for later. Efi, how can you shed some light on payment wearables in fintech?
You know, we all know that during COVID, digital payments of all forms, especially contactless payments, skyrocketed globally, and the adoption really is amazing in all forms. We in FinTech, looking at the innovations in payments, both in store, but also online, we like to look at the trends globally in the different geographies, because of course there's differences depending on geographies, and we like to monitor whether the use of cards or the use of wallets that are in smartphones, but also in a lot of the smart watches. Apple watches is one great example, but not only the Android too. And then to look at, as I said, the cards and this sort of battle, if you want, of what kind of payment will win. And again, geographically, we have different tendencies. What's interesting with the wearables is that there's a possibility to bring these all together. So we could imagine, and there are some wearables, very few, that could handle all these types of payments, meaning they could handle a debit card, or they could handle a credit card, or they could handle a mobile wallet. However, I must say, João, to my knowledge, most of the wearables, the rings, the bracelets, and so on, they are pretty fragmented. Most of them can handle one method. Mm-hmm. What has happened is, for example, you have one bank and they have a ring, and it only works for their debit card. So, and we know that everybody, all of us, have more than one financial provider. most of us have more than one debit card, and if not, we definitely have more credit cards or other cards like loyalty cards and so on. And the other observation, João, is that with the adoption of digital wallets that can hold not only debit and credit cards, but also all sorts of other things like tickets, you know, airplane tickets, other event tickets, IDs in some countries, we want the wearables to do that too. So there's a lot of opportunity there in terms of safe digital identity and of having all these other, I would call them passes, like, you know, it's a pass, the ticket, your airplane ticket is a pass to get on the plane, your event ticket, and so on. So we're not there yet. There are some companies that are trying to bundle, if you want, this. But it's early days and there's a lot of potential, I must say.
Oh, brilliant. Thank you for those magnificent observations. We certainly move in that direction. I actually have an example. I have a wireless ring that does wireless payments. And actually, exactly the point that you raised, just one provider. In this case, it takes MasterCard, but you have to top up and it's only one financial institution. Exactly what you mentioned.
Yes. Anyway. On the other hand, the fact that most of these wearables don't need to be charged, right? You don't need to charge your ring, do you?
Yeah, it needs to be charged. I mean, the elf one, yes. This one, no. This one,
exactly.
No.
Yeah. The new generations, I think you don't need to charge them, which is a very big convenience.
Yes. Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely. For users, yeah. Moving on, Efi. Thank you so much. Moving on, what is your intake on wearables in health?
You know, I have just entered recently that that world. Actually, for me, it is a great, I see it as a great help in terms of being aware of your behaviors, your habits, good or bad habits, and it's a way to support on a journey to have a better life, because in this world we are living in a kind of a bubble and an automatic, right? We get into our tasks, we are busy in our lives, we have a lot of distractions because of this digital world. And we are not aware of our heart rate variability, you know, our stress, you know, all these factors. And that, for me, that is the biggest benefit of these wearables. And I'm not talking, obviously, for people that are in sports or are training and so on. These are also great things. And I do think that with the world of tokens, where we get rewards, and there's some successful ones for different good actions for our health, that is a really great way to connect wearables with incentives, to be social too. You know, most wearables have an app and you can have a community. I like that aspect a lot. And I think that it is ever more important. So again, the question is how to bring the wearable and connect it with the rest of our digital world. Can we have one dashboard where we watch many things, what we choose to watch, among them being health, but others, so we don't have to have 52 apps?
Yeah, that's a challenge. Very, very, very good point. You know, wearables bring a lot of potential, and also around the human behavior, but also they bring some challenges, you know, about like is a new app, is and also some things we're not interested in, they are in our wearable. It's very difficult for the manufacturers to do personalization because it's almost impossible. You producing bulk, and some things perhaps you are interested, some health data, and I'm not. I'm more interested in my sleep. You might be interested in your physical activity. So gathering for different needs is actually a very difficult challenge to encounter.
It is, and as you rightly connect, as you rightly highlight, I don't think that if we have specialized wearables, it would work. So, you know, a wearable only for sleep or only for this, these cannot scale, or they have to be economically very expensive if they're so specialized. So it's a difficult task. Of course, the other big issue is the issue of data, right? What's happening with the data with the wearables? Especially the health wearables, where is that data and who harnesses that data? And data security is a very big issue for the wearables. Of course, for payments too.
Yeah, sure. Brilliant. Efi, coming back to that initial item at the beginning, health and wealth, some people say your greatest wealth is your health. We might argue with that, but how we will see this integration of health and wealth?
Well, I mean, I have seen some emerging initiatives that have not really scaled, where there is a neobank that offers traditionally neobanks offer a checking account, a debit card, but they also offer a membership, a subscription that has basic well-being services. So there's it's connected with your bank, if you want. So in a sense, they're bringing you in this world that your finances and your health are very important, and it makes sense to have a bank connected with health, because if we trust banks with our data of our wealth, you know, our finances, why not trust them with our data of our health? So it's not like they have the specialized know-how, but they can offer these services. So a platform model of, if you want, a platform that includes this. I mean, super apps in the East do these things where they offer, you know, transportation, and they offer social media and everything in one app. I think that in the developed world, we could have a combination of health and wealth. And of course, insurance companies could be a good bridge. But you see, even today, we haven't bundled insurance with banking. They remain separate because of the nature of the business. And we haven't had the model of a platform yet that is successful. There are some neobanks that offer that. But this is something that we might be seeing.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for mentioning that. It's true. It's very important, like two very important aspects of our life, the finances and our health. And the last item that I would like to ask you is, how do you see the future of wearables?
I see it becoming very much ingrained with our fashion. Definitely. It's I from what I'm aware, depending on different countries, it's already caught on with teenagers that you know, wear these rings or these bracelets, because it's really freedom. You don't need to have your wallet, you go to festivals, you go to sporting events, you go camping, and you're really sort of, you don't need to carry anything with you. I personally already go out often without a handbag, which would be unheard of, because basically I have my phone in my pocket. But even that, you know, having a wearable like a ring or a bracelet that can do the basic functions is huge. I personally think, João, that wearables will scale if they manage to be part of the digital identity adoption. You see recently Oura, the ring provider, they bought a company that does digital identity. I think those moves are important. And if we get there and trust is developed, then, you know, I don't need to carry my ID. I don't need to carry anything, really.
Yeah, brilliant. Efi, things are evolving really, really fast, and we're going in that direction. It's been a fascinating interview. Thank you so much for your time and for the expertise, these amazing insights, this overview, emerging fintech and health, and the conversation around wearables, of course. I have one last thing to ask you, which is a healthcare-related question. I'm looking for a short answer, which is related to the channel and my audience in healthcare, is how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
Well, that's a very difficult question, right? Because for the first is because each country is so different. And the second is, what are the goals? As you said before, what is health? I mean, we have, let's admit it, there is a global mental crisis. That's all about health. Then there's physical health. There's different diseases that are, you know, prevalent in different countries. How do we make it better? I think that, you know, our cultures, our education should be more focused on health, and part of our education should be about health and not only about technical knowledge. So we all live a better life and have more preventative ways for our health. I mean, insurance companies are trying with wearables to get involved in this business, if you want, because obviously it is to their interest to have healthy people. But again, we're scratching the surface. It's a small number of people that have this awareness. So we need more education, awareness, and understanding, I would say.
Absolutely. Efi, thank you so much again for this amazing, amazing time that we spent together talking about this very interesting topic. And yeah, thank you so much for accepting my invite.
Thank you so much. It was a great pleasure.
And I'm going to wrap up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to post Efi's social media in here, her Twitter and LinkedIn. Connect with her, ask her questions, engage with her in any shape or form, and also acknowledging our partners. And I'll see you all next week.